Hi guys and welcome to another video. This is my vlog and it is June, so this might be combined with the May and June video that I put up. I can't believe that it's been at least 6 weeks, more like 8 weeks since I did a vlog. It's crazy. So today I'm going to talk about some items that I have purchased, some items that have been gifted to me. We've got works in progress. I've got some finished items. Yay! And I've got some knitting in public. And right at the end, I'm going to have a shop update for those that are interested. So, yeah, time off. Oh my goodness. I can't believe, like I said, it's been so long. I feel like the camera is crooked, but I'm looking at the camera. Let me try and adjust it. Is that a little bit better? So many people that I watch on YouTube, they have these beautiful backgrounds in their gorgeous craft room. That's not happening for me because I need a comfy seat to sit on, and there's not really a comfy seat in my craft room. There's really just a office chair and there's nowhere to set out my stuff. So I'm just on the couch and yeah, I feel really short though. Anyway, you're just gonna have to go with this. So yeah. I've had some time off. I had spent some time with family, with my dad and my sister, best mate and the kids. I went with hubby as well, so we had some awesome times. We were there 3 weeks to spend time with family and friends. We had a great time and caught up with everybody. And ate way too much food and all the stuff that you normally do when you're on a holiday, so that was great. And now, yeah, back to reality. That's all good. I really enjoyed myself, and hubby did too, because he got 3 weeks off. It was almost a total of 4 weeks by the time we got back and everything. And I got some time off work as well, so that was really good. We had fantastic weather, which is always nice. Nothing worse than going on a holiday and getting really, you know, rainy or freezing cold weather. So we had some good weather, so that was really good. And I don't know if you would have seen the vlog I put out, it's probably around Christmas time. It was about my yarn ban and saying that my dad was going to the UK and I was gonna use that opportunity to get some UK yarn. I don't know if you've seen that video, but what was happening, I was on a yarn ban, dad was going on holidays, but I knew I wouldn't see dad for a while after he got back from his holidays. So if I purchased the yarn on my yarn ban, did it really count? Because I didn't actually get the yarn for a couple of months. So I bought the yarn, as you can imagine. I bought the yarn, and so that was, when did he go to the UK? I think it was January? No, February. Went I'm pretty sure it was February. Anyway, let's say February. Went in February, and I didn't actually get to see him till May. So he said he would ship it to me. I'm like, no, don't worry about it. Like, I used him as the guinea pig to bring it back. Guinea pig, is that the right word? Whatever. I saved on shipping because I got it shipped to my auntie's house who lives in England. And then I said to dad, I'll just see you next time and I'll pick it up. So he was going to ship it to me. And I said, no, because I'm trying to save money and that just defeats the purpose. So we have those. Yeah, I'm like totally off track. I don't even know what I was talking about. I've had a hot chocolate. Can you tell? A bit too much sugar. Okay, so let's talk about works in progress first. And I have... I actually have 3 knitting projects and 1 crochet at the moment. Because most of my crochet is for videos and I don't... I've just got this thing, I don't like to show my stuff on videos before it's going to be released. So the things that I'm making at the moment, I'm not really sure when they're going to be released, so I don't like to show them. I like to show them after, it's just the thing I've got. So first of all is an Atwood shawl, and this is a knitting pattern by Nicole Clark. but you may know her as Hugh Loco here on YouTube. She's got a YouTube channel and she does podcasts, and there's a couple of dyeing yarn tutorials as well. Yeah, it's by Nicole Clark. It's a paid for pattern, so I won't show you the pattern. And if you notice black stuff on my nails, it's actually black texture. When I was writing out some post bags, no idea how I got black texture on my fingers. Anyway, so yeah, that's the shawl. And it's got this gorgeous little eyelet edging. And it's quite simple, it's quite easy. But because I wasn't paying attention, first of all, I was making this shawl on the plane to go and see my family, and I was really, really nervous. I'm not usually a nervous flyer, but it was going back to Dad and going back to the family home for the first time since Mum went, so let's not go there. So I was a little bit stressed. So I just wanted something that was really easy, and I've wanted to make this shawl for a while, so I figured, hey, let's do this one. So yeah, because I wasn't paying attention, because I was so all over the place, I put in more rows than you're supposed to be before you do this little detailed section. So I think, pretty sure my stitch count's going to be off. And then I was working on it the other day and did the same thing. So yeah, pretty sure my stitch count's going to be off. But I was talking to my friend Karen and she's saying that the edging is quite simple and you just got to work out how many stitches it goes over. So it might be multiples of, say, 3. You've just got to work out how many multiples it is, and then you can just add or subtract a couple of stitches. So we're going to go with that. So it's a really cool pattern. I love watching Nicole on her podcast. And the yarn I'm using is this one. Don't take any, pay any attention to the state of my cake. It's getting a bit washed out because of the light coming in the window. But it's a light grey with blue, red, and yellow. It's also a sparkle. I don't know if you can see that on the camera. Look at the state of that. My skein winder literally just spat out the cake after it chewed it up. So it's a Turmeric Valley Yarns yarn. And it's called Wintry Rainbows. It's variegated, 100 grams and 400 meters. And it's a sparkle sock, 75% superwash merino, 20% nylon, 5% Selena. And that is the 5% is the sparkle. I don't know if it's showing up very well on the camera, but it does sparkle. So that's my yarn I'm using. I'm using my, I think they're 4 millimeter. I think these are Knit Pro? I think so. If anything's wrong that I'm saying, I'm going to put text across the screen. And they are my circular needles. And this is what I have so far on my shawl. I'm going to try and hold it so you can... So it's a triangle shape. Oh, and it's all curling up because it hasn't been blocked. But see how it's got this detail here and here and there? Well, these sections are supposed to be even in between the little detailed bit, but they're not. Do I care? No. So I have something going on there with a hole, and I also have... There was something else I noticed and I just couldn't stop laughing. Yeah, something there where the yarn has been brought across. I think I might have slipped a stitch. And right at the start of it, there's a couple of mistakes. Like I said, nervous plain knitting. Yeah, really bad. Really shouldn't do a pattern when you're like that. But it's looking really good. I'm loving how the yarn is coming out. And... it's sparkle. I don't know if you can tell, but it is sparkle in real life. So yeah, really enjoying that project. It's an easy knit. I'm only a beginner knitter. I'm not a tell me why am I an intermediate knitter. It's mainly just knitting and purling and then an increases as well. So it is great for a beginner. So I recommend that pattern for you. And this is in my project bag. And this is one of the prototypes that we made for my Facebook group. Love this fabric. I don't know if there's actually any of this fabric left. So cute. All right, so we got that one. I do have notes. I'm so good today. So the next up is my flax pullover. And this is a free pattern on Ravelry. Oh, the other pattern, I'm not sure if I said you could get it on Ravelry. You may be able to get it on Nicole's website, hughloco.com. You may be able to get patterns on a website too, I'm not sure. It's definitely on Ravelry. So my pullover is the Flax by Tin Can Knits, and it's that one, and it's available in all different sizes, so from newborn right up to 4XL. Just trying to find, you can see there's a guy. Oh, this is really hard. A guy and a little baby and a lady just wearing their jumpers. So now my pattern's all mixed up, but that doesn't matter. I know where I'm up to. So I started this on my holidays and I ordered some Bendigo woolen mills because the pattern is written for a 10 ply yarn or a worsted weight yarn. And I wanted to make it in wool, and I didn't have any 10%. I didn't have any 10 ply in wool. I only had it in acrylic, and I didn't really want to make it in acrylic. So I ordered some Bendigo Woolen Mills Luxury in the color Slate, and these come in 200 grams, and they're a 10 ply. Pretty sure it also comes in 8 ply. The 8 ply is equivalent to a double knit. And they're really cost effective. They were $14 or $16 for 200 grams. And for wool, that's pretty good. So I've just got to be careful how I get it out because I don't want to drop any stitches. So I've already used some of this, but you can see how big it is. And it's this gorgeous. It's almost a blue-grey. It's definitely a grey, but even on the camera there, it's got this very slight blue tinge to it. Yeah, that's coming up pretty good on my camera. So I'm onto my... That's my third one. But I did... The bodies took one whole ball plus the remainder that was... the rest that was this one. And then I started a new one just for the sleeves because I didn't want to have to join new yarn in the sleeves and I wasn't sure if that was going to be enough. So here it is, and I'm onto the sleeve at the moment, which I haven't done much of, and I'm using these tiny little needles, circular needles. I think they're like 9 inches or something. So I've just put stoppers on the end so they don't all zip off, because that will make me cry. But I have this much, oh, I can't even fit it all in. I have that much done. And if I remember, I'll insert an Instagram photo. And if I don't, just go and check out my Instagram account and you can see me wearing just this part. Just to make sure it was long enough. And it's a little bit short. I couldn't try it on when it was on the needles. I actually had to cast it off because I didn't have long enough needles so I could try it on. And I didn't want to put it onto waist yarn because I was really scared. I don't know, it just really scared me. And I wasn't sure once I put it on the waist yarn how to put it back on the needles. And I know that sounds silly, but I've never done it before. And I didn't want to get my stitches twisted. And I wasn't anywhere where I could have someone that could help me really, like, really quickly in case I got stuck. So I didn't bother. So I just thought, okay, that looks long enough. I was holding up against my body and I measured it against another top. And it's about an inch too short. So I'm hoping that it will block, because I haven't blocked it yet. And I'm hoping that when I block it, it's going to get a little bit longer. I know it's going to get a bit looser, but I think it's usually in the width rather than the length. And in worst case scenario, if I can find someone to help me undo the cast off, I could probably just add it to the band. So I'm really happy with that. There's so many mistakes in it, but I'm learning so much as well. When I first started this project, I hated it. I had to keep slipping stitch markers over and all these increasings and everything, and I wasn't used to that, so it was driving me around the bend. But now, once I've got past the new things that I'd never really done very much, I'm fine. And if I made it again, I'd be totally fine with the beginning. It's just that I hadn't really done it before, so I was all, I didn't like it. Oh, I'm just going to put that pattern back in there. And it's got this cute little pom-pom. Lovely and soft. The pom-pom's name's Squishy. And this is my project bag. This is the large project bag that was also a prototype for my group that we sell project bags in. This doesn't have the thick interfacing because we do a lot of bags with the padded fleece interfacing, and this one's just got more of a soft interfacing, but I really like it. It squashes down really well, which was really good when I was packing it in my suitcase. I mean, I think the ones with the padding would be fine too, but yeah, it was just really easy to squash. So I've done that one. So my next one is my semi-solid granny square blanket that I'm making. And again, if you follow me on Instagram, you would have already seen some of my granny squares and everything. And I'm sorry if I'm all swishy, but this is keeping me warm. So I have a box of granny squares. Lots of granny squares. And originally I was going to make all different colours and then crochet them together. So I was just going to single crochet them together. But then I had, this box was full up with granny squares, and I thought, I have to crochet those together. And the thought of doing that was just, no way, not doing it. I've totally left the blanket in the other room. I'll be back. So I'm using my Stylecraft yarn. I have a big stash of that. Just acrylic Stylecraft yarn. This is the Special DK. It comes in such a huge range of colours, and I do have most of the colours, but I wanted to try and use every colour that they do in my blanket. That was the original plan, but then I realised I needed at least 25 colours, and I didn't really want to go and buy 25 colours just to make one granny square out of them. So it's probably not going to be that, even though that's going to really annoy me. But I'm trying just to use up stash. I don't want to go and buy, let's say it's, I don't even know how much it is, but let's say it's $4 a ball. I don't want to go and spend that times 25 just to get all the colours. Well, that's like $100 plus, well, it'd be free shipping, but that's like $100 just to go and add 25 squares to your blanket. Doesn't make any sense. So I've got all these colours, and I've just got to get them out of my bag so I can get to my granny's, my blanket. So I've got this bag that it's in. It's huge. This is my Sun Jellies bag, which I love. I got it probably about 2 weeks ago, and it's perfect. It has got so much in this bag. And I bought the bag. I wasn't paid to say that. I just love them. So this is my blanket. and I'm gonna try and remember to insert a photo of the progress that I've got so far. Because I will not get it all into the video. And it's all sort of higgledy-piggledy. You'll see that it's got bits missing and yeah. And yes, there's hundreds of ends to sew in, but hey, I don't care. And the reason that it's all higgledy-piggledy and it's kind of like a jigsaw puzzle rather than strip by strip, I, in all my wisdom, decided after I made all the granny squares and decided that the thought of joining them all together was just going to do my head in completely, that I would join as I go. So what I'm doing is I have all my pre-made granny squares, and these are all 4 rounds of each. And this is using my solid granny square pattern. So they've all got, was it 4 rounds? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. They've all got 4 rounds. And what I'm doing is I'm making a new granny square with 3 rounds. And then once I get to the 4th round, I'm joining it along one edge so that the new granny square and this one that's already made is joined together. And what I can do is I can have the 3 round one that needs to be joined in the middle. And then as I go around and complete each side of the new granny square, I can join one pre-made granny square onto each side. So you can have one in the middle, which is your new granny square, and then one each, one up here, one off the bottom, and one off the side. And then I can join that into my blanket. So I've done that to a few of them and then just grabbed a new 3 round granny square and use that to join to my blanket. Or you can do one here, one here, one here. So top side and bottom. And then on this side, join that into your blanket. Sounds totally confusing. And it kind of is if you don't know what you're doing. But I don't want to join them all at the end. I want to join them as I go so that when I get to the end, I don't have this massive task of joining them all together. I don't have this joining method as a video tutorial. To me, I've perfected the straight sides of the square, but when I'm joining the corners, just haven't figured out exactly what I want to do. And if you looked really closely at my blanket, you would notice the corners are all different because I'm still not 100% happy with how they're joining. So once I figure out what I'm doing, I can teach you how to do it. So that's the granny square blanket. Let's stick that back over there. And I've got all these dark colors that I need to add in because originally I started off sort of on the colour wheel, started at white, cream, yellow, pink, and worked my way through my stash. But now because it's all random, I have to add in random colours. The things we do, eh? Anyway, it's going to keep me busy, to say the least. So that's my granny square blanket, and I'm actually really enjoying that. I love the joining method. It's actually a flat join. Because I know a lot of people don't like single crochet joins because it leaves that ridge. This one is a flat join. It's really good. And at first it was a bit annoying because you kind of have to take your crochet hook out of your work. But once you get into a rhythm, it actually goes really quick. So that's all. No, there's one more work in progress. I'm just going to find the back. One more work in progress kept in my project bag. This isn't a prototype. This is one of the bags that we sold in one of our updates. Well, technically it didn't get to the update because I snapped it. That's the benefits of having them and photographing them. So I get my friend Carmen and my friend Karen to put these together for me. The sewmanship? Is that a term? I don't know. The way they are sewn is so awesome. Look at that corner, people. I love the way the corners are done. We lined them with fleece interfacing. We are going to be also working on some ones that don't have the fleece interfacing if you prefer a soft bag, meaning, I mean, it's not stiff. Look, you can still scrunch it up, but it's padded kind of like a quilt. And then we're also going to do some without that because some people have asked for no interface, no padded interfacing. So yeah, anyway, cool blue zip, awesome lining with these fisheries. And it's got a handle so that you can carry it. Comes in really handy. I go to a knit and crochet group and you've already got your handbag and other stuff if you're taking it. And you can just stick this on your arm. It comes in really handy. And they all come with a Bob Wilson badge. As long as I've got them in stock, you'll get one of those with your bag. Pretty sure this is the medium size. So if you're after prices and everything like that, there is a tab on my website and it will show you all the details. It's a Facebook group and you can go and check them out. So this is the yarn I have. I don't think I have the yarn label. I don't. Don't even actually know if it came with one. But this is so pretty. This is by Felt Fusion on Etsy. Pretty sure that's the right name. Felt Fusion on Etsy, and this is an English yarn dyer. This is the one that my dad got me from England. The other one, the other yarn I'm going to show you in stash enhancement because I haven't used it for anything yet. But as soon as I got this, I had to cast it on. So I cast this on when I was with family and friends. It's so pretty. I don't remember the name of this one. I don't actually know if it had a name. I've misplaced the tag that it came with. So this is going to be a hat and, oops, this will fit me eventually. Doesn't look like it's going to fit me because it's on small circular needles. But I tell you what, if you make hats, I used to use the magic loop when I was knitting. And if you've done it before, you'll know what that means. But it kind of drove me nuts how you had to like scoot all your stitches across and then pull the needle out. And it's really not that bad, but it was just frustrating me. So I bought the shorter needles, and this one you just knit around and around and around. There's no, you know what I mean? There's no scooting across, pulling needles out and stuff. You just keep going. But I do use the magic loop for the cast on. I've taught myself how to knit continental style. But knitting continental style, doing knit one, purl one, I just can't get it to work. So I, English style, so yarn in my right hand for the knit one, purl one for the ribbing. And I do use magic loop for that. I find that a lot easier for magic loop. And I use a 3.5, and this is DK yarn or 8-ply. And then I swap to these needles for the rest of the hat. And then when I get to decreasing, I go back to magic loop just for the decreasing because it gets too small to fit on these needles. It sounds like a lot of stuffing around, but it's really not because I don't knit very fast. So it takes ages to get to the next needle. But I love how this yarn's coming out. It's looking really pretty. I can't stretch it right out because it'll fall off. But yeah, very cool. And I don't know if this is what everyone's does or if it's just mine, but when you cast on and everything, you get like this little bump bit here. Is that normal? Because I just, when I finish, I just sew it and sew it so it's flat. I just want to know if that's normal. So any knitters, can you just tell me if that's normal? It probably is, but it doesn't really bug me. It doesn't worry me at all. So that's my work in progress that I can show you. There's 1, 2, 3 works in progress to my, because I'm obviously on the couch and my, just here, is the other side of the couch, and that's where my works in progress sit for the video tutorials. So I've got what did I say? Three. Yeah, three works in progress. Two are garments, and one is for around the house. So I can tell you that much. So I'm just looking. Right, so that's my works in progress. Finished items. This finished item at the filming of this video is not actually out yet, but it will be very soon, and I know that this video won't be released till after the tutorial because, well, I just know it won't be. This is, oh god, it looks huge. This is the granny bag with handles. Awesome to take to the beach. It looks really big. I mean, it is a big bag, but it's not as big as what it looks on the screen. You could fit two adult sized beach towels in there, plus sunscreen and a few little bits and pieces. So it's made in the granny stitch with the two handles. There are other handle options I make on other bags, and I will be listing those in the description of this video tutorial, this video when it comes out. But I don't show you how to do that in the tutorial. I show you how to do these handles. But if you followed other bags of mine, you could probably very easily adapt it to go on here, because most of my handles, you do a single crochet or a half double crochet border around the top of your, whoops, top of your bag, which is like this, and then you add your handles on, so you would just follow it for the handle section. So that's my first finished object, and that's actually my latest finished object that I finished the other day. This is my, I'm calling it my flax hat, but it's not called that. I think it's called Barley, I think. I'm going to put it across the screen if it's different. And this is another Tin Can Knits pattern, but I followed the pattern wrong. Yeah, I got a thing about doing that. So this is supposed to have, so it's a free pattern on Ravelry. It's supposed to have, I'll show you what. So this bit is a purl and that bit's a knit, but every second row across here is supposed to be a knit. So it's supposed to go, so you knit, 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 and then you purl across, knit, knit, knit. But then on the next round, you're supposed to knit and then knit all the way around. Yeah, well, I didn't read the pattern, did I? Or I did and I didn't sink in. So mine looks like this, and the actual pattern doesn't look like that. It looks so funny. It's the weirdest shape. I also made it too long. Oh, it just gets better. It's for me. Oh gosh. I also made it too long. Where's the, oh, now I can't even tell where it is. I'll turn it this way so you can see it. So I made it too long. I didn't follow the pattern, but it still functions as a hat. Oh my goodness. After I'd finished it, I thought, why doesn't mine look like the pattern? What, like the photo in the pattern? And I don't know, where is that? Can you see that bit? Like, as you can see, it's too long. So if I wanted to pull it right down, I'd probably have to just fold it up a little bit. Hats don't look very good on me sometimes. What is this? Seriously. So this might be my going out in the dark hat or just around the house hat, or like, it really, it's probably really not that bad, but it kind of bothers me that it bothers me because I know the pattern's wrong. But it's lovely and warm, and this yarn, let's take this off. Ugh. I just crack myself up sometimes. I don't follow patterns. I should read. Read the pattern. So this yarn, which is gorgeous, by the way, is by, okay, I'm going to get this wrong. It's either feather brush or feather bush. Really should have wrote that down. It's a New Zealand yarn dyer, and I got this yarn at the Unwind Festival that I went to in March of this year. I stalked her on Instagram and saw it, and I thought, oh, can I please have one of those? And she very kindly put it away from me, so this was my very first purchase when I got to Unwind. Which, I love the yarn. The yarn is gorgeous. But I'm really angry at myself that I did the hat pattern wrong, and it's also a little bit too long. But it was a 200 gram ball. I've got no idea what I would do with the leftovers. It must be in my stash somewhere. So I'm going to see how much I've got left. I know it didn't use 100 grams. So I'm going to see how much stash I have left and then make myself another one. But using, like, following the pattern this time. Because it's lovely and squishy. Feather brush. Ugh. Where's my phone? I don't even think I've got my phone near me so I can look it up. I don't even know where it is. Anyway, like I said, I will put the name across the screen if it's wrong. So yeah, lovely and squishy. So that's my... Oh, that's my second finished item. Sorry, I am trying to follow the list so I don't forget anything. So, another finished item of mine is a shawl. And you may have already seen this video tutorial. I love this shawl. I wore it the other day and I actually got lots of compliments. So, and I have a pink one that's identical. So this one is... I haven't written the name down. I'll put the name across the screen of the name of the tutorial. And this is using Turmac Valley Yarns again. I'm a big fan of Turmac Valley Yarns. And this was her... Again, I didn't write it down. Her Dragonfly Gradient. So as you can see, it just gets lighter. That almost looks white on the screen, but it's not. It's very, very pale green. It's actually really pretty. It's like a mint. Then it gradually gets darker. And I just wrap it around. And then the other day when I wore my pink one, I just grabbed one of the corners and then just tied that in a knot. Because it's a really odd shape, so people weren't really sure how to wear it. Just tie those corners in a knot, and then you can just put it in your jacket. You don't have to tie it in a knot if you don't want to. So yeah, love that yarn. Nicole's a beautiful person. She's got a website and Facebook page, and she's on Instagram too. And if you've watched enough of my vlogs, you'll know that I'm probably addicted to her yarn. And that is so squishy. So that's my video tutorial for that one as well. It's also got a free ribbon pattern. So my next video, my next finished item. Oh, I can't actually show it to you because this is a secret, but by the time this video comes out, this person will already know. I sent it to my friend. That's hilarious. I was supposed to keep it for my vlog. Anyway, I sent it to a friend and it's the Bias Granny shawl. And I will insert a photo because I don't have it to show you. I used Unforgettable Yarn in the Candied colorway. And it's so soft and squishy. It's an acrylic yarn. But it's gorgeous. The colour changes are really slow, so it just looks really good. So, Jessica, surprise! But by the time you get your parcel, because it's already in the mail, and you should have it within probably the next 5 days, and I know this video won't get edited then, so. Yeah, you've got that shawl, and it's very, very pretty. So yeah, that was my other finished item, but yeah, sorry, I can't show you. So what else have we got to talk about? I'm just going through my list. So I've showed you the felt fusion yarn. That was the gorgeous rainbow that I'm making a hat out of. And my other yarn stash enhancement was this yarn. It's a superwash merino and it's called Emerald City. It's by Kate Celine. Look at that. This is, it's like a bright apple green. It's looking a bit washed out on the camera. I think because of the, it's a bright apple green. It's looking a lot lighter on the camera, but oh, it's so squishy. This is her business card. This is an English dyer, and this is one of the yarns that I got my dad to grab. Because I have been stalking this lady on Instagram and had that colorway in my favorites on Etsy for forever. It's so squishy. Is it merino? Oh, yummy. Superwash merino. And it also came with a little sample of soak. It's the stuff that you wash your garments with, your garments. And I've never tried it, so I'm very excited about that. So when I make something up, I'm going to try it out with that. Oh, it's 100 grams and about 200 meters, and it's a DK. I've got to show you again. It's just so nice. And it's got speckles of, I think it's a black. The lighting in here today is terrible because it's miserable outside. It's raining and cloudy. So it's not very good light. But it's either specks of black or it could even be a really dark purple. But I think it's black. Oh, it's so nice. So nice. Cannot wait to use that. Who knows what it's going to be. I do wear hats in winter, but I wear shawls a lot more. But then I've also got a lot of shawls and a lot of scarves. So we'll see what that's going to be. It would look really good in fingerless mitts. We'll see. I have no idea. I just think it's really pretty. So other things that I've got just sitting here, I've just noticed. This was going to be in the update too. For the project bags. This is our Notions size, the Notions pouch. But this one didn't make it because I love it. So that's a crochet hook. This is a clover, I think. Yeah, that's a clover crochet hook. So you can see the size of the Notions pouch. And I keep my scissors, the crochet hook that I'm working on at the time, because it will go in with a project, scissors, sewing needle, tape measure, you know, things like that. So my next project bag enhancement, stash enhancement, because I've got a lot of those. I was on Instagram scrolling through, as you do, and I saw this bag and I just said, mine. I have to have that bag. So it was on Tammy's Instagram from Girl So Sheepy. So I messaged her straight away and said, I need that bag. Please send it to me. So she set up a listing on Etsy and I bought the bag. And I have it here, and I've had it for probably for about 3 weeks, but I just haven't had time to do a video to, I'm gonna take it out of the bag, and it's come with some tea. So I took it out of the parcel bag that I got sent in, because I was just too excited not to take it out. But I've left it in this bag so I can show you what we've got. Oh, so it's got this adorable little stitch marker. What is it? Oh, it's a little octopus. It's so cute. It's adorable. Oh, that's not focusing. Focus. And then a Australian afternoon tea bag. Very cool. And the project bag. I'm a sucker for skulls. I don't know why. I really don't. It's gonna be some rustling. I don't know why. I just am. And especially these ones, are they sugar skulls? Well, sugar skulls, I think it's a bright colours against the white. And then if it's against black, well, you've got me. I am sucked in all the way. Oh, we've got a business card. Let me get a bit closer. So that's all her details, and if that's not coming up on camera, it says Girl So Sheepy, and on Instagram, Ravelry Podcast. I don't think I follow you on YouTube. You've got a YouTube podcast, which if I don't follow you, I will be subscribing. And you've got a shop on Etsy, which I already obviously know because I bought the bag. And there's also a blog. So all the information is there. I'm hoping that's focusing. And here's the bag. It's so pretty. And there's a label as well. The fabric's awesome. I really don't know what it is about those skulls, but I just love them. They're very cool. It's just all the pretty details that they have. And there's coloured ones every now and again. So yeah. Love it. What's on the inside? Ooh, I've got a white lining, which is really good when you're trying to find stuff. It's like having a black lining on your handbag. Seriously, why do they do that? Everything just disappears. Yeah, so white lining. Perfect. Love it. What's going to go in there? I don't have any new projects, but maybe I can swap something out. So thank you, Tammy. Love it. That fabric. So my name's Claire and I have an addiction to project bags, yarn, crochet and knitting. And I don't want to be cured. Love it. Did I mention I love the bag? So thank you. And I did purchase this bag. I have not been sent this to advertise it. This is my own opinion. So yeah, just wanted to put that out there. Oh, I am surrounded with stuff. Not that you can see it. And I think my couch ate my pen. Okay, so the next section is gifted items. I was gifted a pattern on Ravelry by Mrs. Smith 615, and this is Andrea. I didn't know anything about this. I just went into Ravelry and checked my messages like I do. And I noticed I'd been gifted a pattern. Thank you. I've already messaged you anyway via Ravelry, but thank you so much. It was the Pure Joy knitted shawl, and I'm going to say the name, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to say it wrong. I've heard the Grocery Girls podcast say this name 500 times, probably. And I was practicing the other day, and I still can't remember how it's said. Is it Hohi? It's J-O-J-I. Hohi? It's not Hohi. I apologise if, not that this person would ever watch my podcast, but let's just say Hoagie. It's like a telly. I can say the last part. I just can never get the first bit. And it's a beautiful, beautiful shawl pattern. And I've been watching the Grocery Girls, and a couple of other podcasts have mentioned it. And a lot of people are making this shawl. And yeah, it was gifted to me, so thank you. It's a paid for pattern, and that's why it was gifted. And yeah, thank you so much. Maybe my new skull bag can be my pure joy shawl bag. And I'm pretty sure in the pattern you've got to pick a couple of colours. I know it's at least two colours because it has some detail through it. And it's got short rows in it, I'm pretty sure. I did a quick read of the pattern after it was gifted to me. And I think it's got short rows in it, which I've never done. So that's something I can learn, which is really exciting. I like to pick patterns. I like to do patterns that I can learn at least one thing in them, whether it be crochet or knitted, so that I can gradually learn how to knit. I don't want to jump in the deep end and just learn a heap of stuff at once, because that's not how my brain works. It needs to slowly learn something. So yeah, so it's got short, I know it's got short rows in there, which I'm sure people have done short rows going, it's really not that hard, but I've never done them, so very exciting. But I do have, as you've seen by my works in progress, and that's not all of them, trust me, there's plenty more, but I tried to cut it down so it wasn't so boring. I've got lots in progress. Oh, and I've also got my, what's it called? Oh, the Duchess Shawl by Kay Jones from the Bakery Bears podcast here on YouTube. I've got my Duchess Shawl, which I have done. If you've made this pattern, you'll know what I'm talking about. I'm done up to the edging, so I haven't started the edging yet. I'm pretty sure that's my next step. As far as I can remember, I've finished the last garter section. Again, if you've made the pattern, that'll make total sense to you. If not, you're probably thinking, what? It's a really great pattern. It's great for beginners like myself when I started it, who have got the knit stitch. And I'm pretty sure you could purl in it a bit too. The knit stitch and the purl stitch, you've got that down pat. And I'm trying to remember, I think it's got yarn overs and knit front back, which sound really hard if you've never done it, but it's really not that hard. So it's got a little bit of learning, and I'd never done eyelets, which is easy once you know how to do it. It takes a little bit of practice, but it's literally a yarn over and knit two together, which when you've never done that sounded really scary, but trust me, it's not scary at all. So it's got that in there. So I got to practice my knit front back, because I've never done that before, and also my yarn overs and knit two together, which I'd never done before as an eyelet. I'd done knit two together as a decrease in a hat pattern, but I'd never done it for the eyelet rows. So yeah, I get to practice that. And trust me, by the time you finish that shawl, you will be an expert at all those stitches, because it's used throughout the pattern. Great pattern. Yeah, I can't say enough about that pattern. It's a paid for pattern. It's on Ravelry, and I highly recommend it. It's gorgeous. As soon as I saw that shawl, this is when I very first started knitting. As soon as I saw that shawl, I thought, I don't care how hard it is, I need to buy it. And I did. And I think I practiced for a couple of months, and then I thought, I spoke to my friend Karen. You might notice I mention Karen a lot. She's my knitting guru. She's mine and my friend Carmen's knitting guru. And also my friend Jessica. I ask her a lot of knitting questions as well, because I don't know enough about it. So Karen kept saying to me, you can do that shawl, it's not hard. And I'm like, no, it's got all these things in it. She's like, it's not hard. Once you've done it, you know, you'll be able to do it. And personally, when someone who's got a lot of experience says it's not hard, I think, yeah, sure, it's not. Of course it's not hard for you, because you've done it a million times already. But I'm slowly learning to trust that person and think, well, okay, maybe it isn't hard. It's just a little bit of practice involved. So yeah, awesome pattern. And I'm up to the edging on that. And I might actually not do the edging and just cast off. Some of you have made the pattern and are going, no, you've got to do the applied border, which I've never done, so that'll be another thing I get to learn. But I'm at this stage with my projects where I've got so much on the go, I just need to cast them off or finish them off. And I was watching the Bakery Bears, Kay Jones, who's designed the shawl pattern that I'm talking about, and she was saying, you know, at this moment when they were doing the filming, that I don't know if it was her personal life or her knitting life, so to speak, she was getting overwhelmed with projects that she had, and it's time to cast them off. And I'd been thinking about casting it off this shawl pattern a couple of days before I watched that video, and I thought, now is that a sign? Because the person whose shawl I'm making has said she's at the point where she wants to cast off the things that, it's not that I'm not enjoying it, I'm loving that pattern, it's really good. It's just I have so many things, and that pattern's at a stage where I can cast it off and it will still look really cool. But will I regret casting it off and not adding the pretty edging? I'm really struggling to find time to sit and knit it, and it's been at the stage it's at the moment for 3 months. So that kind of tells me that I'm not going to find time. It's cold at the moment, as you can tell. I've got this on. And I want to wear it. So I'm thinking I'm going to cast it off so that I can enjoy the knitting. There's no use having it sitting in a bag for 3 months. I mean, it has been warmer weather, so I hadn't needed to wear it. But there's no use having it sitting in a bag for 3 months because I'm thinking, oh, I have to find time to do the border. Anyway, that's enough about that. So I may just cast that off and you'll see it in the next video. Hopefully. I think that's pretty much it. That was my phone just giving me some sort of update. Ah, dear. Just checking my list. And two more things. One's a shop update. Oh, three more things. I've got to talk about this. When I got my skull bag, the day it arrived, my friend Carmen came around, and Karen, and Elena, and Jess, another Jessica, that's Carmen's daughter, came around to dye yarn. We had a dye day. It was so much fun. We had so much fun. We ate heaps and heaps of food and drink and dyed yarn. It was really fun. And she brought this with her as a little gift, and it was by sheer fluke that skull bag turned up at the same time. So this skull bag turned up as a gift. It's getting really dark in here. And then this was a key ring that she gave me. So I haven't tried it yet, but I'm going to see if that key ring thing will fit onto the zipper. Turn around. Don't you think that just has to go with that bag? I think so. So what else was I going to talk about? Oh, Knit in Public Day, which was Saturday just gone. Was that the 11th of June? I don't know. Can't remember. But it was Saturday just gone. And myself, my friend Carmen and Karen, that I talk about on the video, we went to Knit in Public Day, and it was in the Arts Gallery in Dunedin, and yeah, it was really good fun. There was lots of people. There would have been, oh gosh, between 20 and 40, maybe 30. A lot of people. Anyway, we were in a big circle, and we're all sitting around, all different ages. So it's technically a Knit in Public Day, but you can crochet as well. And there was a couple of crocheters there, and I took my knitting because my crochet projects, I was kind of at a stage where everything was at a stage where I couldn't take it with me and just crochet on it. They're all at a stage where I have to concentrate. But my Atwood shawl that I showed you first with the sparkle yarn, that's pretty easy to do. So I took that with me, and not that I knitted much on it because I was too busy talking to people. And I took a few samples of video tutorials that I've done, so just the finished items. It took a few samples with me and that got passed around, and they try to make me the lady that was running it was trying to make me do like a presentation, like get up and talk about my stuff. But if anyone knows me in real life, I do not do public speaking. I would have just got up, fumbled all my words, gone bright red, like I'm talking, glowing the dark red if that's even possible, and just froze up and not been able to talk. I can talk to this camera because I'm literally sitting in my lounge room by myself. But yeah, there's no way I could have got up and spoken in front of all those people. I don't know. It's just not me. It's really not me. So I had said to her before that, I said, I'm not a public speaker at all. Like, I really don't like it. And and she introduced me as a special guest. And then she said, come up and tell us a bit about your company or your business. I was like, no. So she said a few words, which was really lovely. So I had a bit of a laugh about that. But yeah, and then so my items that I took, I took a scarf and a couple of shawls, a cardigan that I did, my V-neck cardigan that I did with my King Cole yarn, the bright colours. And I took that along with me, and they all got passed around. So as they were getting passed around, I was talking to the people sort of one-on-one, or like just in a tiny group of people, which I'm comfortable with doing that. I can do that. But I really can't do big crowds. So that was really good. So I got to go around the circle and, you know, talk to people about the videos and the patterns and what yarn I used for the project and where they could find my tutorials and my written patterns and etc. So I handed out lots of business cards. It's getting really dark in here. Like I said, it's a terrible day outside. So yeah, I had a really good time. So did you go to Knit in Public Day or Crochet in Public Day? Or do you go to a knit group? I actually go to two knit groups. I go to one on Thursday night, and then there's one I go to every second Thursday morning. Two completely different groups. The one in the morning is older ladies, which are an absolute riot. It's so much fun. And it's more structured. The lady that runs the group sort of does lessons if you want to join in with the lessons, and she'll teach you some stuff. Or if you don't want to, you can just sit there and crochet. And then the Thursday night one I go to, that's more sort of around 40-year-olds. Sort of, there's just some younger and there's some older, but that's probably around 40 is the average age. So yeah, so you get different ideas from different generations. Like, different age groups have different ideas and what they want to make. And this group on a Thursday night is the talent. I mean, the talent on the Thursday morning is amazing too, but the talent in the Thursday night in the knitting, because it's more crochet on the Thursday morning and it's more knitting orientated on the Thursday night. God, the talent with those ladies, seriously, is out of this world. They bring in their finished items to show people, and it gets passed around the circle, and I just sit there and go, yeah, never gonna be that good. They use really, really fine yarn and these most delicate, beautiful patterns. I mean, yeah, one day maybe I'll be that good. Hopefully. I can only wish to be and hope to be that good. But yeah, they're just gorgeous. And the lady that runs it dyes her own yarn, so every now and again she brings in yarn that we can buy, and I have so far resisted. Why? Why I've resisted? Who knows? Why don't you just buy all the yarn if you like it? Buy it. But I have resisted so far. But that can only last for so long. I've been really good lately. Am I lying? Touching my nose, does that mean I'm lying? I've been really good lately. I went through a huge yarn buying stage, like ridiculous amounts, just seriously did not need it all, so therefore I have a huge stash. And I bought yarn at the Unwind, and I think I bought three or four of the pink to make my cardigan, and then I bought two or three others. So I probably bought between 6 and 8 or 9 skeins of yarn. So that's quite a lot for one day shopping. And then I've bought the ones that I showed you on this video, and I think that might be about it for since March. So that's pretty good. So I'm kind of getting itchy fingers. And the yarn that the lady that runs the group's Morag, and she's got Vintage Pearls, which is online, and I think she's on Instagram, online, I'm pretty sure she's on Facebook. And she sells her yarn, and it's really, really pretty. She does lots of solid colours, but the colours that she does are just really nice. So it's only a matter of time. What on earth was that? Something on my phone. It's only a matter of time before I buy something. And saying that, I bet this week she has some yarn. And to make it worse, she brings in what she calls defects, but they're not defected. They may be slightly under 100 grams, or there might be a knot, like a join in the yarn, which to me is not defected. That's just, you sometimes expect that, don't you? Like, it's not always going to be the exact amount that it says on the label, and there are going to be joins. But yeah, her colours are just, oh, so pretty. My pink cardigan that I bought her my yarn from, love, love that colour. I'm not a pink girl at all, but the pink yarn is gorgeous. So, and there was some oranges and some purples last. It's really strange. The colours I don't go for are the ones I really like of hers, because it's just the, I don't know what you call it. Is it the shade, or, I don't know. So I'm not a pink girl, but it's the pink that she dyes up. It was really bright, so that appeals to me. So very exciting. Way too much yarn in my stash. I donated a garbage bag of it recently to the Salvos, which is like to thrift stores. If in America, if you don't know what Salvos is. So I donated a heap of that. I also took in probably 2 shopping bags worth into my Thursday morning group. It's falling off the shelves in that room. It's just ridiculous. Yeah, and here I am saying I'm going to buy some more. Anyway. Double checking. Yep. That's all I've got. That's all that was on my list. I was doing a monthly vlog, but somehow it changed to 2 monthly, because sometimes I don't really have anything to talk about. There's nothing exciting happening. It's, you know, it's just normal life, working and doing the groceries. Really nothing exciting. So yeah, you don't really get anything. But anyway, I think I've talked for way too long because my camera's telling me it's almost out of memory, which is quite scary because I think that's about 45 minutes. But that won't all be on this video. I will edit some of it out because, yeah, there's bits that don't need to be in it. But yeah, I think that's all I've got. If you could see the stuff that I'm surrounded by, you'd have a fit. And I don't know if you can hear that, but someone's messaging me, so I need to go and check what that is. So I hope that you are having a great day, evening, morning, afternoon, whatever it is where you are when watching this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Happy crochet. Bye. Did I mention that I was surrounded by stuff? Ooh, the stuff up on the top there wasn't in the video. It's a secret video. It's a tutorial, and so is most of that stuff there. Not the project bags, but the stuff underneath it, this green and
thingamajiggy. What's this? Oh, that's just a shawl. Knitted shawl. Pair of knitted, what do you call them? Da-da-da. Fingerless gloves. But all this stuff here, that and all that junk was just all in the video. See you, bye.